You already heard my name and my title, so I guess I can directly jump to my next slide. And so I prefer to say in beginning and stress in the beginning that, of course, everything that I show is a huge team effort. Yeah, and having such a slide is also dangerous because it's never possible to list all the people who really contributed. But just to point out a few, so there's a big collaboration within Jena with the groups of Thomas Perch, Frank Setzfand, Veit Einberger, and Andrei Turchanin. We also closely collaborate with Australian National University, where I was previously, and here Dragomir Neshev and Yuri Kivshar are my main collaborators. And also Igal Brenner's group at Sandia National Labs is an important collaborator for us. And I also show some work where we collaborated with Alexander Moravsky and his team. So the outline of my talk is as follows. Yeah. So I will start with some motivation and introduction, which is a bit more general. And then I will talk basically about the three topics that I promised in my title, namely tunable semiconductor metasurfaces, light-emitting metasurfaces, and nonlinear semiconductor metasurfaces. And yeah, there will be a very brief conclusion then in the end. All right, so allow me by starting to give you my cartoon picture of what an optical metasurface is. Of course, most of you will know this. So what we have is basically a sheet of nanoscale thickness here, which is oriented out of the projector plane in this image. And then we come in with some known input light field, like for instance, a plane wave. And the metasurface transforms this into an output light field with desired properties, which can be spectrum, polarization, wavefront, and so on. And how does this metasurface do this? And here, yeah, the magic is really in the structure. So this metasurface is a two-dimensional sub-wavelength arrangement of designed nanoscale building blocks. And really, by designing these blocks and their interaction with light, the metasurface is able to impose many, many different functionalities onto the incident light field. So we can also approach this concept of the optical metasurface from two directions, I would say. Yeah? So one is coming more from this direction of optical metamaterials, like these bulk metamaterials, where the designed building blocks were arranged in three dimensions, and the light wave averages over all of these building blocks because they are arranged on a sub-wavelength scale, so it sees some effective properties. And these can be engineered then by the arrangement and by the properties of the individual building blocks. These bulk metamaterials turned out to be quite tricky, both fundamentally and also, of course, from the viewpoint of fabrication. But if we basically thin down now the metamaterial to a single layer, so basically doing a 2D metamaterial, if you want, then we end up again with the concept of the metasurface. And the other